Welcome to the Ordinary Annuity Calculations Tutorial using the BA2 Plus Calculator. I'm Joshua Emmanuel. Ordinary annuity simply implies that payments are made at the end of the payment interval, like at the end of the month or at the end of the year or at the end of the quarter. Let's look at a few examples. Example 1. Find the future value of $400 payments made at the end of every month for 5 years if interest is 3.2% compounded monthly. In this example, payments are made at the end of every month and interest is also compounded monthly. Payment interval and compounding frequency coincide, so we refer to that as simple annuity. We start by pressing second PY. PY basically stands for payments per year. Since payments are made every month, there will be 12 payments per year, so we enter 12, enter, scroll down. It is also compounded monthly, so we enter 12, enter, and then we can quit that mode. Next, we enter the time value of money values and then compute future value. So for N, we have 5 years and payments are made at the end of every month. So total number of payments will be 5 times 12, which is 60 payments in total. So we press N. Interest rate is 3.2. We press 3.2. IY. And then present value, we don't have present value, we just have month end payments. So we'll do 0 present value. And for the payments, we enter them as 400. I'll make them negative because money is going out. And then press payment. And we compute future value. So the future value is $25,989.15. Let's look at another example. Example 2. What is the present value of payments of $250 made at the end of every quarter for 12.5 years at 7.5% compounded semi-annually? So in this case, we see that payments are made quarterly, but the interest rate is compounded semi-annually. Payment interval and compounding frequencies are different. So we call this general annuity. So again, to begin, we need to set our POI, second POI. So payments are made at the end of every quarter. Quarterly payments require that we set POI to 4. So we press 4, enter. We scroll down. Now this is compounded semi-annually, which means twice a year. So we set CY to 2, enter, and then we quit that mode, second quit. Next we enter N. In this case, we have quarterly payments made for 12 and a half years. So we have 12.5 times 4. Okay, so that is 50 payments altogether. And then we'll press N. The interest rate is 7.5%, 7.5 IY. We want to compute the present value, so we don't have that. We skip that for now. Payment is 250, so we enter that as 250 negative payment. Since there is no future value, we set future value to 0. 0 future value. And then we compute present value. So the present value is $8,096.11. Thanks for watching.